Hello and welcome to the Planless podcast. And I'm having a bit of trouble streaming recently, and I'm really sorry if this cuts out. But I'm going to attempt to go at it again. So, I think this is Planless Project podcast number 11, and we are going to use Conifer Biome by these guys. Pixelgoat. And it's very, very nice. And I think currently they've got a sale on this one. So yeah. So I just want to make sure that I'm streaming. Hope it doesn't cut out. So let's start. So we've got environment light mixer, and you can find that in window, and it's where all your lights live. So skylight, atmospheric light, sky atmosphere, volumetric cloud, high fog. Post-processing volume in there as well. Make sure this is clicked on. Infinite extent unbound. My exposure I like to set to 1:1. All of that is going to go in a folder. I'm going to create a landscape now. So go to landscape. I'm not going to import a height map or anything like that. I'm just going to create my own one today using alpha brushes from Brushify. So this landscape material is found here in the Nordic Conifer Biome material library, and I'm using the tessellation version. In. And here's the landscape material. Which is very, very nice. So that's one of them. Here's moss. These alpha brushes can be found in Brushify packs. The latest one, the Mars pack, has one, and the Arctic pack has one as well, which is cool. I think I'm going to use the Arctic one. And this has four brushes, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I'm going to use the red channel first, make this super large. Zoom out. Start sculpting. Choose another channel. So I'm just going through here and just making
our landscape. I don't want anything too high on this one, I just want some slight undulation. Some nice details in there. Okay. Give that a quick play. Trees procedurally using foliage volume. Procedural foliage volume. I'll put one of these guys in, set it to zero, and I think it's 250, and that will fit a cube all around your landscape. And what I'm going to do now is scroll down a bit where it says procedural foliage, and I'm going to go to procedural foliage in here, in this folder, Nordic Conifer Biome, and there'll be a folder there for procedural foliage, and yep, I'm going to start off with large rocks first, and then press simulate, which is down here. Boom, there you go. So give this a quick play. Now you can see that we've got these awesome rocks that have been procedurally placed across the whole landscape, which is amazing. So I'm going to do that a few more times. So one of these guys, zero that out, go 250, and we're going to scroll down, put some logs in here, simulate. Some of these are going to take ages, some of these might just take a small while. This one might take ages. The larger your landscape, the longer it's going to take. So that's added some logs, which is cool. I'm a little bit dubious about copy and pasting these guys, I've had some issues with it before, so that's why I'm doing it singly. Rocks. Simulate. Nice. Some of them might take ages. Okay, that's good. Another one. Fill out the scene quite well with the trees. There we go. That's pretty cool. And one more. think this one takes quite a while as well, so just let it do its thing. Incredible that, you know, we're able to create these epic worlds very, very quickly in Unreal. Like, there's like mushrooms and stuff, which is pretty cool. Landscape to fit with that if you wanted to, but it's literally just for background. So if we just let's go a little bit further, let's say here, just to give you a rough idea of what we're talking about. Landscape to blend into that very, very easily. Okay, cool. So, we haven't played with water too much, so I'm thinking putting a river through here, so let's do that. Water body river. So let's bring that right down. So that's it. So it's actually cutting into our landscape as opposed to making a epic. It adds a post-processing volume underneath the water, so yeah, it just helps it look a little bit more realistic, which is cool. The whole thing needs to be cut into the ground a little bit more, so that's cool. So we just select our spline. Let's get into the landscape a little bit more. Sort out all these trees shortly. So, as you can see, you've got that stuff floating. So that's okay. Simulate. This is definitely going to take ages. I'm going to re-simulate them all at the same time. gentle. So as you can see, it's resimulated all across this river. Surely there's a way to... Oh, right, okay. Just on the landscape alone, I wonder if this will work. Okay, so that's better. That's cool. So with these little ones, what we can do is go to foliage. Just select our trees. All of these guys, all of this. This. Press shift. Ah, and it crashes. Temperamental old thing, isn't it? Unreal. I love it, but yeah, you know, you've got to do all these things. So yeah, I'm just pressing shift. to delete these guys. Log out Revel. That's really cool that there's like a felled tree. Volumes that you can set up that actually stops this. Much like how you set it up to create procedures, you can actually do the opposite. So you can have a blocking volume, basically. But this shouldn't take too long. Once it's done, it's done. A bit more realistic now, it's actually digging into the landscape as opposed to just like it's really digging in there, which is really cool. So that's our other landscape, isn't it? Okay, cool. So let's sort that out. So that's this guy and this guy. Just drop them down, just however much. Now hopefully, yeah. There's still some there. I wonder what this is then. It's interesting. There's mushrooms growing under the water. Now I don't know what that could be. It's quite interesting. So let's just go through it. So it's not a landscape. This guy. So that fixes that. So, yeah. So that's how you create rivers. The material for it is very advanced as well. I haven't looked too much into it, to be quite honest. It's the Unreal water tools I haven't used too much. They're very, very good, there's no doubt. Like the colour of it, I'd prefer it to be a little bit more darker. So I wonder if we could do that. Let's try and find the water material for it. So here's the water material. Let's find its home first and create another one. So we don't damage it. Thank you, Theodore. That's really awesome of you. Thanks. Just dealing with some Unreal business here, and so it's just preparing shaders currently. Cool, that's acting very strange now, so. Yeah, that's really weird. As you can see, it's glitching. See if it's alive. No, it's not. And I don't know why that happened. I could not tell you what happened. So it's glitching out. Hard. It's the default one there. No, don't want to know. How odd. Theodore, there's hope we can fix it. I'm sure we can. It's just, this is what happens. I'm kind of glad that it's happening, really, because this is what happens sometimes, you know? So, let's just close it, go back in. See what happens. Preview. Let's have a look. So it looks like it's still broken. Yeah. So. Goodbye, water. Right, okay. I'm not giving up. So, river. River body. No, I think it's actually still doing it with a brand new... Yeah, it is. That's really weird. Okay. I'm not going to give up, man. So, let's get our landscape. Let's not import from file. Let's get editable layers, all of that good stuff. Yeah, create. Yes, yes, yep. So this is a complete new level, so water body. Right, it's something to do with the level. That sucks. So okay. Back on. It keeps on crashing, man. Like, OBS is not my friend today. It's too much. Press Alt, creates a new node. does it work? So look. Yes. Right. Foliage. Procedural foliage volume. Bag. 250. What I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna do them all at the same time. So let's do that. That's gonna be this guy here. So large rocks, logs, rocks, swamp, trees, undergrowth. Don't need the last one. Select all of these guys. Right, let it do its thing. It says, I'm from Japan, but I can't understand the live stream. Thanks for sharing anyway. Hopefully, there's previous tutorials where I go much slower. The only reason why I'm going so quick is that it's crashing and the stream's not behaving very well. And unfortunately, I only speak English. I think maybe there's ways to put subtitles up. They auto-generate, so that could be interesting. Maybe that's something I should look into. So, hopefully, all of this will just generate a foliage across the whole landscape. Let's see what happens. And as it's generating like so much, that's why it's taking so long. Awesome. Right, let's save this. Map 8. That's good. So we've got some rogue trees here, which we can fix. Do that. Let's go foliage. Select all our trees and whatnot. Unreal, I love you, but Jesus Christ, sometimes.
That's really interesting. There's one of the trees looks really amazing. I'll have to look into the meshes, find out what's going on. Okay, let's give this a play. Okay, we're good. I know we had to do that like 3 times just to like show you guys how that works, but yeah. Let's do some cleanup. To get a post-processing volume in here. In she goes. Set that to infinite. Exposure, bang, bang, bang. One. Okay. Save. A plane sticking through, looks like it. Okay, we can fix that. Okay, that's odd. Hello Peter, let's go man. Yeah, I'm just kind of struggling with this one. It's you know, normally I just do like landscapes and I don't really play around with water too much. Yeah, let's see what happens. So yeah, the resimulation takes ages now. I wonder if you had a really beefy CPU, then it would cut through this. Or a smaller landscape. Thank you. happens, eh? Thank you, Gates Hawley. That's very kind. Thank you. Let's just, try and make something nice out of it. I'm going to get a camera up soon and then play around with some more meshes. So 32 cores, yeah, that'd be nice. That'd be very, very, very nice. I don't have that, unfortunately. I think I've got 16, which is like insane, but for this type of thing, definitely need 32. So let's have a look. Yeah, his assets are glorious. So let's get some one in the light and I'll show you how it looks. They just sit so beautifully into the landscape because obviously that's how he created them. But it's very, 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 very nice. And I think, it's mental. It's pretty mental. So, yeah, this is the part that I really enjoy. Obviously, you know, like creating levels and whatever. I really don't enjoy the crashing. I really don't. Let's keep going. There were some trees that he had that were amazing. But yeah, this beast. That's for foliage, alright, okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, the assets are really, really nice. So over here, let's play around with these other paint materials. So let's go landscape, paint these layers in. So we're currently just using mulch. If we go to moss, reduce this bad boy down. Yeah, so around these type of areas, obviously where it's been damp, you'll probably get a lot of moss. So that's what it looks like.
Yeah, so Theodore, the virtual production, I've been working with virtual production recently and it's on my mind. Virtual texture, yeah, definitely. I don't think it's set up currently. I have another material currently that does have that. So the way to find out would be, you know, if you, you know, you chuck that tree in there, you know, you would have the landscape material blended into it. That's currently not happening because I haven't set up the virtual textures yet. Lost in this world. Yeah. So what this layer does is create puddles, which is really cool. Don't know if you guys can see that. See where it's muddy, so this would be like the perfect texture for like right next to where the water is, you know, lead up into moss, then into grass, which is cool. We've got another path material here. It's a bit quick. That grass is working correctly, but never mind. Yeah, so this is the path material, which is pretty cool.
just want to find out what's going on with this grass material. So it's paying down the material but not the foliage, which is odd. So it just doesn't want to know, does it? That's a real shame. So, out of curiosity, I would like to know why it's not working. So, yep. Right. Okay. So it's not working. Okay. Yet this one is. So you can see that it's adding foliage when you paint, much like with the moss. Alright, yeah. The moss is incredible. But the grass is not functioning. Oh, there we go. Random. Completely random. Completely random. Right, so let's go back into our other world. Interesting. Very interesting. And jarring, but yeah. So that's nice. Give that a quick play, see if it works. Yeah, nice. So I think really just like a massive big up to what's his name? Pixelgoat. This fella. It's a really beautiful tool. It really is. You know, I'm only really scratching the surface with it as well. This is pretty in depth. and I'm sure there's ways to help this river as well. But yeah, again, I haven't really played around with it too much, to be honest. It's like tropical, isn't it? It's a weird colour. Now I'm too afraid to change the colour because the last time I even tried it died. Yeah, watch the subtitled version later. Yeah, let's have a look at that and see what happens, man. Should definitely do that anyway. I want some moss, please. Yeah, I don't know what to say really. Just like, just that alone is just like incredible. The fact that, yeah, I'm kind of lost for words really. It's just like, it's, yeah, depending on what you want to do, like, this is kind of like perfect. Path material where people have been walking, and then, you know, we've got this area here, maybe some grass over here, just paint that in. Yeah, it's playing ball now, which is nice. Potentially some muddy leaves over here, and it's a bit too tough, so let's go to like 0.5 on that, and just so it encroaches without being too harsh. See, that tree wouldn't really exist there, would it, really? So let's do a little test. So if I get the landscape tool, and very subtly sculpt this area. Okay, that's very cool. So you can, as you can see, everything's kind of moving with it now, which is very, very nice. Well, that definitely sounds like an awesome rig. This is very interesting, the fact that it's working like that. That's really, really cool. So let's go to path. insane. So I'm just like exploring the scene, like it's just it's ridiculous, man. Like the detail in these assets are just incredible. Setting up a sequencer now. So wherever you point the camera, it's just ridiculous. Yeah, it's very, very nice. Make a Windsor castle and bring the royal family together. I do have a castle kit, but I'm not sure if I could bring the royal family together, mate. Thank you, Peter. Yeah, it's it's Unreal, and it's packs like this can facilitate very fast scenes like this. And you know, UE5 is just, yeah, it's just looking absolutely crazy these days. This is the latest version. It's looking really good.
Yeah, I love Cinema 4D still, and Octane, but you know, UE5 in particular, you know, it's looking really good. The fidelity's there. Is yeah, it's definitely the future. There's some tools in it that, you know, that Cinema and Maya just, you know, they're just made for certain things, you know. It's like animation, character creation, you know, motion graphics, you're going to be going to them programs, but it doesn't mean that you can't, you know, create something in there and bring it into Unreal. And that's what's so cool, is the fact that it can handle so many different programs these days, and different assets. Yeah. So the frame rate is incredible as well. Oh, it's bouncing off 40 FPS. Once solved a rendering of a shot that used 1 terabyte of space. That's absolute insanity. What program was you using to get that insane number? I suppose this is more of a review than
than anything else. Whoever was chatting up earlier about virtual texturing, yes, it does have it, and that's why it's blending, I think. Let's just have a check on the material. Blend texture, yeah. That's really cool. Okay, I'll just leave it to what it was. I think it was 3, wasn't it? Well, that's awesome. Okay, next. I love beefy birds. Gotta have beefy birds. So his assets, their assets, incredible, absolutely insane. That's cool. Done a soundtrack to a movie. Oh, well done, man. Yeah, in a past life I was a musician, and yeah, it, I know what it takes. It's a tough game. Yeah, the blends on this are absolutely insane. So, yeah, before we do that, save this. Yeah, Peter, the water is I'm not even a massive fan of it, to be honest. There is others out there. Like, it's kind of like a tropical water. I'm not a fan of it. What I might even do is actually get rid of it. What happened there? You know, there's, I think what it is, it's just lack of knowledge on my part. I just think that it needs it just needs more time on it. And it's just the curve is like terrible. That's what the problem is. Yeah, water's an absolute killer, mate. It's tough. See, the colour of the water is much better. I think that's all we needed, really. It's like, nah, it sucked. It sucked. I need to get on it. Oh dear. Jesus Christ. That's very sweet of you to say so, Peter. Like in the description, I'm just trying to have a laugh with it. For me, it's very cathartic. I just really enjoy just. Kind of an escape. Ooh. One of those doesn't have a collision. That's interesting. Okay. Cheers, guys. I really appreciate you sticking around and witnessing this, whatever this is. I don't know. I just enjoy playing around, I suppose. Thank you.
the moss layer is insane. Jesus. There we I don't like seeing duplicates. You can see that this is the same thing.
I like the shadow. So insane. This is very, very odd. It should flatten, not do that. Give up. What does this rock want to do? Sinks up with the collisions on these rocks. crash.
Yeah, probably for the best. Didn't save for a while, so that's a shame. I'm just very, I really like the, pack. I think it's very, very good. And, yeah, spend hours doing this, and I most probably will. So, for now, I suppose. See you next time, guys. Ciao. Bye-bye.